No fairy tale. This is no sugarcoating or blurring of the lines. This is no joke. This is life. Life that cannot be paused and rewinded and edited. Life that cannot be a lie. A series of words and actions to prove to the world that you can't possibly be you. Because being you is absolutely outrageous. Why would anybody want to talk to you, to associate with you, to love you? They say the only barriers that exist are those we build ourselves. But they can't account for the people and systems that help us. In this digital era, this has become common. To plan, to arrange, to embellish, to edit, to lie, to expose. And the man who is generally considered an expert in this is a man called Julian Assange. Julian Assange was born July 3rd, 1971, in Townsville, Australia, and lived a childhood of constant movement with his family. He went to nearly 37 different schools and quickly learned how to harness his genius IQ to his advantage, for good or for worse. Even back then, Julian was dedicated to revealing the things that people kept hidden within the depths of the web. And through it all, he kept a moral high ground, claiming that he would not be part of something that only assists the military, and dropping his college degree in defiance. With his talent, he worked on and off for several high-profile hacking companies, until in 2006 he founded his greatest legacy and creation. Opened in Sweden, WikiLeaks was, on paper, a simple side idea with moral high ground. To quote, WikiLeaks will accept restricted or censored materials of political, ethical, diplomatic, or historical significance. We do not accept rumor, opinion, other kinds of first-hand accounts or materials that is publicly available elsewhere. At first, it started out as nothing more than your standard information dump for things that the public didn't quite know about but wasn't really a secret. The public could openly post on and edit it. This was only phase one. Phase two began with a much louder bang.
We got an RPG.
All right, we got a guy with an RPG.
I'm gonna fire.
Okay. No, hold on. Let's come around.
We can't build these right now from our point of view.
Roger, but
yeah, we're gonna come around. We'll get some on. So let's get all individual all RPG. Getting ready to fire. We won't get.
Yeah, we got a guy shooting. Now he's behind the building.
God damn it.
Speed coming around.
He was right in front of the Brad. About there, 1 o'clock. Haven't seen anything since then.
Just fucking, once you get on, just open them up.
Yeah, Roger. I see your element. You got about four Humvees out along this.
You're clear.
All right, firing.
Line here. When the stage line, let me know when you have it.
We'll shoot. Light them all up.
002 traffic, 260.
Come on, fire.
The hidden video of the Iraq Apache helicopter attack, which killed 13 innocent Iraqi civilians and two Reuters journalists, was a massive controversial topic for a long time, but that was only the first. Other secrets came into light soon enough, like the human rights issues that came with a handbook that was given out to those who had been captured and put in Guantanamo Bay. The secret Bibles of the Church of Scientology. University students fudging results to greatly enhance the actual statistics of global warming, with over 10,000 letters posted online. WikiLeaks had followed through with their promise, and they had delivered with a glory that could not be matched. News of this site spread like wildfire, gaining infamy by the minute. Due to its fastly growing nature, not all those who posted online were as lucky as to have their secret hidden, like the soldier who released the helicopter video, Bradley Manning. However, many could keep their identity anonymous. And through all the legal charges it faced, some as recent as today, the site persisted. WikiLeaks is one of the most infamous cases of how easily secrets don't remain secrets anymore. Many people have often claimed such sites like Twitter, Instagram, and Facebook are famous for how someone's identity is changed by the internet. But many have forgotten that secrets run deeper than expected. No delete button is permanent, and no amount of virtual recycling will make your greatest secrets disappear once it's posted. And as WikiLeaks claimed its places in social media, its infamy only grew. Julian was not held accountable for what was put on the site, from a legal standpoint at the very least, but the dangers of it were quickly put into full public view. The government could not shut it down, that would be asking for a free speech lawsuit, but they all remained on the tips of their toes in fear for what a disgruntled civilian might decide to post. The site stood by the words, "True information did good." But unfortunately for Julian Assange, his own truths would come back to haunt him.
It was started back in 2010 when two women told police that Assange had assaulted them in Sweden. He's always maintained his innocence, though, and sought asylum in London's Ecuadorian embassy in 2012, where he has remained ever since.
In early December 2010, Julian was under investigation by Swedish police for two counts of sexual molestation, one harassment charge, and one rape. Julian eventually turned himself into the London police after a European arrest warrant was sent out by Swedish government on December 6th. On November 2nd, 2011, Julian's appeal was dismissed by High Court. Still in conditional bail, Julian went to the UK Supreme Court. According to New York Times, protect Mr. Assange from British arrest, but only on the Ecuadorian territory, leaving him vulnerable if he tries to leave the embassy to head to an airport or train station. Cites the possibility that Mr. Assange could face political prosecution or be sent to the United States to face the death penalty. The case eventually stopped due to violations in the Ecuadorian community, according to Swedish police. The case will expire in 2020. Even after the case had been left out to dry, Julian had quite a peaceful time. But this was not the end for Julian Assange or for WikiLeaks. Even with its founder stuck within the embassy, WikiLeaks continued working, and at staggering amounts. 2.4 million emails dating back from 2006 from Syrian politicians, government ministries, and companies are published, and nearly 800 classified US documents are published about the alleged terrorist attack activities of Al-Qaeda capturing a house in Guantanamo Bay, amongst much more. Its international infamy did not diminish, even as some doubt was beginning to be cast on the authenticity of the documents they were posting. While Hillary Clinton and Donald Trump were endlessly fighting, WikiLeaks and Julian returned to the headlines. In early July, WikiLeaks released more than 1,200 emails from Clinton's private server during her time as Secretary of State. Later, WikiLeaks released an additional emails from the Democratic National Committee that indicated an effort to undermine Clinton's primary opponent, Bernie Sanders. WikiLeaks had now entered its third stage and showed no signs of stopping. Julian Assange, a man full of legacy. He's one of the leading hackers in the world, calm and controlled, speaking in a measured tone and pace, When he talks, his vast range of interests also surprises one, from computers to books to traveling in Africa. But he's the kind of person, according to him, can hack into the most sophisticated computer system. And he can forget to show up for an interview or cancel at the last minute. We're going to crack the world open and let it flower into something new. Social media is a powerful tool that can make or break someone's existence. More and more people are looking at your life online. If they don't appreciate the image you made for yourself, then most likely neither will anyone else. Social media is neither good or bad, it's only what we make it to be. Because we are in the day and age of new and improved technology. What will you do?